Today, I will tell you about some precautions and basic operations of the CPU jumper wires. Before the jumper wires, confirm whether these points are useful pad. Some pads are non-functional or grounding line, loss of them requires no jumper wires. Use the multimeter to measure the resistance at these useful points, and you can find out the line that connected to the missing soldering pads. After that, we use the blade to scrape it. Be careful, and the scope of scraping should not be too large, because this line is next to the grounding line. If the line and the grounding line are scraped together, there is a risk that they will be short-circuited with the grounding line after tinning. Use tweezers to dip a little tin on the wire. It is actually easier way than a soldering iron. We only need to put 2 to 3 tin paste particles. Remove the excess directly. The excess solder are removed directly. After it is placed, it can be blown with a hot air gun. Add solder flux paste. Cut a small copper wire and place it near the end of the thread. Then use the hot air gun to heat it and weld it with the wire. Clean up with the PCB cleaner. Apply a thin layer of the UV curable solder mask. Cure for about 1 minute with the UV curing light. It takes a little patience to make a circle. You can see that because the wire is not fixed properly, the wire will come loose when you make a circle. This is one of the caveats. The wire must be welded or fixed. We did it again, apply a thin layer of the UV curable solder mask. Cure for about 1 minute with the UV curing light. Wind the copper wire around the solder joint. Make a new circle to cover the pad. After making the circle, apply a thin layer of the UV curable solder mask, cure for about 1 minute with the UV curing light. Then scrape out the copper wire after curing. Measure the resistance again to confirm that the jumper wire are not abnormal. There is also a note, when flying the wire, it is best to weld it obliquely, which is convenient for turning.